everyone, and welcome back to another episode of Pet in a Day. And today we have put a video together in the memory of Heather O'Rourke.
We'll talk with the mother of the late Heather O'Rourke about the death of the child actress.
In other showbiz news, as Poltergeist 3 opens around the country, the memory of Heather O'Rourke continues to make headlines. The mother of the star of the three Poltergeist movies has filed a wrongful death suit against the hospital and medical group that treated Heather.
They're back!
Heather O'Rourke sadly won't be back. 7 months after she finished filming Poltergeist 3, the child star was struck with flu-like symptoms that became very severe. She was being treated for inflammation of the bowel, and as her condition deteriorated, her mother called an ambulance.
She said she loved me, and then she suffered cardiac arrest in the ambulance. And then they operated on her after they were stable, and they told me she had a congenital blocked intestine, had died of septic shock. Mm-hmm. And the next day, that's when I got to thinking, well, this isn't what she had.
What they thought she had was a bowel inflammation. What she actually had was an obstruction. And the difference is they were treating her medically with drugs, whereas in fact what they should have done almost a year before her death was to operate and remove this narrowed portion of the bowel. And that's a fairly routine procedure, and had that been done, I've been told that she would have been fine and led a normal life.
A spokesman for the Kaiser Foundation Hospital, one of the main defendants in the wrongful death suit, has said the diagnosis and treatment was correct. Bill?
With the death of Heather O'Rourke and several other stars in the Poltergeist film, supermarket tabloids immediately began running stories of the films being jinxed. Zelda Rubinstein is in Poltergeist 3, playing her now familiar role of the clairvoyant. When we sat down to talk with her, we asked what she thought of the jinxed stories.
I owe it to Heather to present her case as most honestly and lovingly as I can. I loved this child very much, and I am still very grieved at her passing. Heather died because of an undetected congenital anatomical defect. Julian Beck died from cancer in his mature years. Will Sampson passed away after receiving a heart-lung transplant. It's my understanding he had an environmental disease. And Dominique Dunn died at the hands of an extremely ill-directed, passionate boyfriend. These are reasons. I do not call this a jinx. So I think that it's pretty much a courtesy to put to an end this superstitious crap.
There were also stories published that during filming, scripts would mysteriously vanish and objects would fly around the set.
No, I've never had any experiences like that.
Okay.
No, I think it's hype.
The objects we do see fly around can be credited to special effects people. And of course, some chills are courtesy of Zelda as Tangina.
Can I?
A character Zelda Rubinstein hopes to continue playing, even, sadly to say, without Heather O'Rourke.
I believe that there's room for more. And a lot will depend on the public demand.
The end of today's episode, and catch us in our next episode of Back in a Day.